To add a lollipop chart, you first need to select the metric you would like to add the visual to. We're going to add it to variance for the plan percentage, and we have two options available. If we come up to the lollipop chart on the home ribbon, by either the positive or negative colors by default, or we can color the markers, the positive and negative colors. To start with, we're going to select the bar colored lollipop. Now, by default, the column width is automatically assigned based on the data, but if you wanted to manually increase the size, you can drag and drop it to the desired size. Additionally, you can further configure it by coming up to the Customize ribbon. And over on the left, you can choose to change the template either from the bar or to the markered colors if you'd like. Coming over to Appearance, let's go to Series Display. You have a few options available. The marker type can be changed from default, which is the square, or you can set it to circle or diamond. The marker size also has four options available. We have wide, compact, normal, or mini. You additionally also have an option to change the maximum chart width. Now there's one additional option in Appearance that requires a different template. If we close this and change the template to coloring the markers instead, come back to Appearance and go to Series Display, you'll see that down here now there is an option for line color to color the line now that the marker is being colored by the KPI colors instead. Closing the Appearance window, coming back to Appearance and going to General, here is where you can set the positive or negative colors. Additionally, you have the option to change the axis direction from left to right or right to left, as well as an option to invert the variance. If you select this, all of the positive colors will become negative, and vice versa, the negative colors will become positive. Go ahead and set this back. The data labels will also be important. If we turn this on, we also have an option to set outliers based on above or below a certain threshold. If I select this and select Enable Outlier, I'm going to set my negative threshold to minus 18 and my positive threshold to 35. Select Apply, and you can now see the markers show up when the threshold was either exceeded above or below what was set. And last but not least, you have an option to change the fill pattern between solid, outline, or hatched. And since the plan over here is indicated to be outline, let's go ahead and match up the visual to be outlined as well.